Francis Cornford, the guitarist, tunes up. With what attentive courtesy he bent over his instrument, not as a lordly conqueror who could command both wire and wood, but as a man with a loved woman might, inquiring with delight what slight essential things she had to say before they started, he and she, to play.